Honorable ministers here present, Commissioner for Economic Affairs at the African Union Commission, Chairperson of the Association of African Central Banks, Vera Songwe, Executive Secretary of UNECA, Distinguished Central Bank Governors, Director of African Department, International Monetary Fund, Development Partners, Distinguished Guests, good morning. It is my pleasure to attend this 2019 Symposium of the Association of African Central Banks, representing His Excellency Paul Kagame, the President of the Republic of Rwanda. On his behalf, I wish to welcome you all to Rwanda and thank you for being here today. I thank the Association of African Central Banks for convening this important event in Rwanda. I also commend the Association for its commitment towards Africa's economic integration. Your presence here demonstrates the role of this body in bringing together African central banks to work toward a common goal. Distinguished guests, 54 years ago, the Association of African Central Banks was established to promote cooperation in the monetary, banking, and financial sphere in the African region. It was also meant to assist in the formulation of guidelines along with future agreement between African countries. Since then, African economies have gone through significant mutation despite numerous challenges. The growth path has generally been sustainable for the last two decades amid economic diversification and financial sector development. As the global economy continues to evolve at a higher pace, policymakers and the central banks are the key player to address new challenges to ensure that Africa continues its transformation journey in line with the Agenda 2063. Currently, with the modern financial ecosystem, we are dependent on central banks to safeguard our individual countries' monetary policy and the financial systems. They also help to set standards and the protocols that make it easier to have intercontinental transaction of goods and services. In that regard, central banks are instrumental in promoting and facilitating financial deepening and inclusion as one of the drivers of investment and business expansion, modernization of payment system and reduction of transaction costs in exchange of goods and services, cross-border banking and ease exchange of currencies, and economic integration of the African continent. Therefore, despite numerous challenges like recurrent commodity prices shocks, other external shocks, and external imbalance, in some cases, African central banks have contributed to ensure macroeconomic stability. The association's role in bringing these central banks under the same umbrella to work together under a common goal should be applauded. Distinguished guests, the African Continental Free Trade Agreement is aiming to create a tariff-free continent that can grow local business, boost intra-African trade, promote industrialization, and create jobs. This is one of the main solutions that can come from a united Africa collaborating to address the health of the economy and of the region. Further to this, countries and the region have signed different treaties, developed cooperation models in order to trade to each other, share knowledge, experiences, and support in solving various economic challenges. As the policymakers, we should work towards implementing our commitment and the treaties. For instance, it is common for African countries to source from far away products that can be produced by closer African countries due to a lot of transaction costs incurred from a bunch of trade regulations and tariffs that make intra-African trade inefficient. Distinguished guests, allow me to close my remarks by welcoming you all once again and wishing you productive deliberations and a very happy and pleasant stay in Rwanda. It's now my pleasure to declare the 2019 Symposium of the Association of African Central Banks officially open. I thank you for your kind attention.